Bocelli back with you. Hi, thanks for tuning us in. Happy Friday night and all that stuff. You know, you should have one of these puppy attached to your suit.
That'd be neat.
It would be. And if you've just joined us, this is the lovely and talented Laura Eubanks, who you met in that pre-recorded bit before. Hi. Thanks for coming over.
Thanks. You're welcome.
Let me see the accent. Where are you from originally? Chicago?
Chicago.
Chicago.
Everyone can tell.
Say Chicago.
Chicago.
How do you feel about the new baseball stadium?
Did they put up a new baseball stadium?
Oh, never mind.
I used to go to Cubs games all the time. I was faithful. Every Saturday. Yes, Wrigley Field.
What's the new one called, Fred?
Comiskey Park.
Misty Park?
Comiskey.
Oh, Comiskey Park. That's right.
We could never go to that one.
How long have you been down?
8 years.
8 years, yeah? Mm-hmm. Did your family move and all that? They brought you when you were just a little puppy?
Right.
Do you miss the winter at all?
At Christmas time, I miss the snow. It's nice.
I came down from New York. It was pretty weird at first. I've been here like 5.5 years, and it was very strange at first.
I thought so too.
You know, like, but did you have like a major hard time with the heat at first too?
Well, yeah, I did, and now I've adjusted. And if it gets just a little cold, I think it's too cold. I think, how did I survive those winters in Chicago? I don't know.
Yeah, it's crazy down here. It's like when it gets to be 50 degrees, you know, you walk out, it's like, damn, it's 50 degrees out there. You see that 50 degree Monday? Yeah, it's nuts because people don't realize how it is when it's 50 below.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So congratulations, you were also one of the finalists at Knickerbocker. And how did it feel when you won?
It was exciting. I love winning, hate losing, of course.
You don't lose many, do you?
Have
you entered many?
Yeah, well, you figure, you know, 50-50, you win some, you lose some.
That's got to be awful to be sitting there and, ladies and gentlemen, the contestant that wins is not you! And you have to smile at a bitch. I hope you get hemorrhoids, you bitch. That has to be awful, huh?
Part of the game.
Part of the game, yeah. Well, and if you win the big prizes, you know, I understand Jean-Michel has just a special loving for you. Have you met Jean-Michel?
Yes, we have met.
He wanted to ask me that if there's any chance in hell that if you win the big money, you might, like, you know, buy a Porsche.
Take him on a cruise.
Yeah, would a cruise be all right, Jean-Michel?
Be great.
Yeah. All right.
Is there a chance in hell of that?
Sure. Why not? I'm easy going.
Whoa, easy going.
Not easy, easy going. Oh.
What's the difference?
There's a big difference.
Yeah.
Big word.
Mm-hmm. What does it feel like, though, really? There you are, standing in a club. There was a million people over there, half naked, prancing around. What's going through your head?
I don't really think about the crowd. I just know what I have to do, and just I see the judges. Really, that's what I focus on.
You should do that the night before.
And my mom.
Oh, your mom was your mom?
She goes. To, yeah, she goes to every pageant. You didn't?
Oh.
She's great. She goes to every pageant with me.
Is she a fox too?
Oh, she's beautiful.
What's her first name?
Celeste.
Celeste. Did she tell you?
Yes.
Oh, come here. Celeste. Oh, sorry. I need this. Wait, I'll be right back. Oh, damn. This is supposed to be a professional show. Celeste. Sono molto lieta di parlare con te. Quanto tempo vuol dire che può parlare lentamente, per favore? Okay, there you go. Does she speak Italian?
Yes.
Oh, good. She's probably mine. Do you know what I said?
No.
I
don't speak Italian.
I don't want to say it in English. What's with this, Michael? Look at this. My mic keeps coming off. I'm discombobulated here. We're trying to run this as a professional show, isn't it a joke?
Are we on TV?
Yeah, not really. This is kind of just like Mike's little fun party. I bring my guitar, I play loud, and I play some, you know, my favorite videos. Neat job, isn't it?
It's a neat show.
Thanks. Do you have to work out, or what do you do? What's your secret?
I work out every other day.
Yeah?
Mostly aerobic activity. I jog, too.
Do you do those, like, workout things that, you know, you put the tape in and then you work out like crazy? Or anything?
My sister has one of those at her house, and I'll do that once in a while with her.
Wow. Mm-hmm. What's your sister look like?
Great. Her name's Jeannie. She's real tall. She's beautiful, too.
Jeannie. Wow. How about your dad? Is he good looking?
Yeah, my dad's great looking.
The whole family is like major.
Well, I'm like, of course.
Sure. You're one of those families where you go to church and everybody's sins. They're just what they're thinking in their hearts. All right, we got to watch a video. You're going to hang with us. And if you've just joined us, Michelle will be back, too. And we got to bring Tom on. And Tom. Mm-hmm. He's smiling. Oh, he's smiling. What's the next video? Is it Prince, Fred?
No.
What is it?
Yeah.
It's Prince? Prince. This is Prince. Hang out with us. Laura's here. You're there. Papa Cole won, and I'll be back before you can say grandmother and grandma live inside a mayonnaise jar. Watch. Bocelli Kelly back with you. Thanks for tuning us in. Welcome to the show. And if you've just joined us, this is the lovely and talented Laura Eubanks, who's Bob Eubanks' illegitimate love slave, I guess. I don't know what she is. Just kidding. And she's a fine, we'll tell you in a minute, representative of an exciting bikini contest going on. But first, we have to get to this, because this is really why they watch, besides the fabulous babes. Great videos this hour, wouldn't you agree? Music by Megadeth doing Hangar 18.
Scorpions, Winds of Change.
Bad Company doing Holy Water.
Black Crowes, She Talks to Angels.
I love your accent, it's cute. Robert Plant doing Tie-Dye on the Highway.
Great White, Desert Moon.
Yes doing Lift Me Up. It's a countdown show, friend.
Black Sabbath, No Stranger to Love.
And Aldo Nova, after a 5-year hiatus, is doing what? Blood on the Bricks. Okay, and we're going to kick it off with Faith No More momentarily. Back with the lovely and talented Laura. Now, if you win, I guess we should do this again, too. Look at all these prizes. She's a finalist. She'll be back in 7 weeks, which will be a grand slam fun time, I'm sure, at Knickerbocker on the Water, US 19, in Countryside, vying for $50,000 in cash and modeling contracts, $25,000 in modeling contracts with Becker's Models of New York. I asked Michelle, so I'm not putting you on the spot, too. I don't mean to be fresh on them, but did you like have an ugly duckling stage?
I was real shy when I was younger. I was real skinny and puny and never left the house. I was a little mommy's girl. And I cried my first day of kindergarten. I wouldn't let go of my mom's dress, she said.
Kindergarten, that's expected. But I mean, like when you were growing up and stuff, you know, in your teens and high school stuff, how were you doing then?
I was always pretty decent looking. Yeah. I was never like ugly duckling.
Decent looking. I'm still waiting for my decent looking period. Yeah, so you never went through one of those stages, huh?
No,
you're lucky.
It will happen now.
Yeah, maybe in about like 10 minutes everything will fall.
No.
I didn't mean that. That's good. But a lot of fabulous babes, you know, that you talk to, they say they went through this like major thing. And I guess it always leads up to the fact that, you know, if you went through that ugly duckling stage, now you'd be able to slam all those people that wouldn't talk to you then. You know what I mean? Like them old boyfriends and
like
stuff.
Like high school reunions.
Yeah. Do you have any other gigs besides parading around in clubs half naked?
I work for my parents.
Yeah, what do they do?
They own a flea market and Italian restaurant connected to it. It's really neat.
Wow. Is that, I guess you could get crabs extra cheap there. What's that? How does that work? I'm sorry. Flea market and Italian restaurant?
Celeste Famous Spaghetti in Bellevue, Florida.
Less Famous Spaghetti.
Celeste, my mom.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you said Less Famous Spaghetti. Fred, they use chitlins.
Oh, yeah. No chitlins.
Where is it at again?
It's in Bellevue.
Where?
On 441, south of Ocala.
Oh, cool. Yeah, are you there like on a regular basis?
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
There you go. You're going to be inundated now with maniacs who watch this show. Coming in there going, I want, never mind what they want. That's good. Is there a phone number they can call? Let's plug that too. How do they call for reservations?
245-3532, area code 904.
Very nice.
Or actually, it's 245-FLEE.
Oh, jeez. Is that F-L-E-E?
F-L-E-A.
We heard about this chef. He has some kind of venereal disease. No! Kidding. F-L-E. Now, wait a minute. They got a flea market and an Italian restaurant side by side.
Yeah, there's a big building, and that's where you have the Italian restaurant. It's really nice. There's a gazebo in there. It's really neat. Yeah. And then outside, there's 100 sheds or different stalls for people to set up their stuff.
The old Italian men with their corncob pipes out in the sheds? What?
Yeah, you know, selling stuff from their garage. Little old ladies with their jewelry, you know, whatever.
Is it indoor then, entirely? Indoor?
Yeah, under sheds.
That's
and
good.
Then the restaurant's indoor in a main building.
What do you do there? In what capacity do you work?
Well, I work in the restaurant, and I serve spaghetti. A waitress.
As a waitress?
Mm-hmm.
No way.
And my dad's the chef, and my mom,
oh,
she's kind of like the hostess. And my sister, she's the other waitress. Her name's Jeannie.
This is so cute, it can make you puke. Isn't it? Jeez. What a nice Italian family.
Mm-hmm.
How cute.
Well, actually, my dad's German.
Isn't there? Oh, well. How the hell did he get in there?
Well, he got lucky.
Oh, well. What was I going to say? Isn't there like a whole spaghetti line of stuff called Celeste Spaghetti? Is that you guys?
Well, see,
no. Your mother's first name. That's their last name, right?
Well, Celeste is her name, so we can use, you know, Celeste Famous Spaghetti, because to us it's famous.
I want to come out there sometime and get some of your mom's home cooking.
I tell you, $2.95, and you get this big plate of spaghetti.
She's going to charge me.
So delicious.
Boy, you really trained him good, Tom. The next line, even if it was BS, should have been, oh, sure, Mike, bring your whole crew, and we'd be more than happy to take care of you. But no, $2.95.
I just wanted to get
just
to the
Just have
prices.
A menu there in the back of my tea bag for you, Mike. Jeez.
I just figured I'd get the price in there. Free
advertising. That's good. $2.95 for how much? All you can eat?
No.
And what do you charge? Sorry. Should we get her to stand and spin and embarrass her?
Yes.
Would you mind? Because there's guys now in prison, captive audiences. Ladies and gentlemen, the effervescent and really talented, there she is, Laura. Laura, you're looking great. What's the next video? Is it Faith No More?
Yes.
Faith No More, hang out with us. There's Laura. Tom's up next and other stuff, and both babes will be back. Bye. Thanks for tuning us in. No, I haven't died and gone to heaven. That's just the lovely and talented. Let's see. It's backwards. How's this go? No, yeah, there it is. Michelle and Laura over there, and we'll be talking to them momentarily. Thanks for tuning us in. We certainly do appreciate it. Remember, you're watching WTMV TV 32, the station it pays to watch, and we are surrounded by half-naked babes in honor of the bikini contest going on at Knickerbocker on the water. We'll tell you more about that momentarily, but first I gotta let you know about the videos that'll be playing on this fine hour, because why, geez, this is a video show. Crowded House is here doing Chocolate Cake. Any of you girls like chocolate cake? You guys like everything sweet and sticky, don't you? I know it. Elvis Costello doing The Other Side of Summer. Paula Abdul doing Rush Rush. It's a pretty cute video, actually. Aretha Franklin and George Michael doing I Knew You Were Waiting, and yes, it's true, George Michael actually gave Aretha Franklin a bikini wax for that video. Janet Jackson doing Love Will Never Do. Janet's looking nice, Michael. Hit your button, show yourself. There's my producer, Michael P.
Yes, she is.
Janet Jackson showed up with a bed of romaine lettuce, some lemon garlic, and some anchovies. Would you let her make a Caesar salad for you?
Yes.
I knew you would. Dave Stewart doing Lily was here. Stevie Winwood doing One and Only Man. The Beatles from the movie Get Back doing Get Back. Or is it from the movie Let It Be doing Let It Be? I don't know. And Concrete Blonde doing Everybody Knows. And Phil Keaggy is going to kick it off doing March of the Clouds. So I think we should just get to the videos, because I know you guys are going to want to meet the Goyles in person. So let's just watch Phil doing play some real guitar. It's kind of a misnomer for me to lead him in at all, huh? So maybe I just won't. Maybe I will, damn it. It's my show. Here comes Phil Keaggy. Watch this. Can't play with these babes hanging around me. Michelle back with you. Thanks for tuning us in. If you just joined us, this is Laura and Michelle over here, finalists from Knickerbocker. Hey, Fred, there ain't a prayer in hell that he's playing right now.
I don't think so.
It's amazing the guitar even sits this close to my person right at this moment, if you know what I mean. The finalists from Knickerbocker on the Water, which is on US 19 in Countryside. If you get a chance, Thursday nights are the big pageant nights, right? Now, are you going to be hanging out this Thursday to see who wins, so you see who your competition is?
Well, I'm 2.5 hours away, so maybe yes, maybe no.
Maybe no. But you will be back in 6 weeks.
Definitely.
So if you'd like to meet Laura up close and personal-like, is it 6 weeks from now, Thursday night? We should know the date, but we don't.
August 15th.
August 15th. August 15th. Hey, you're a genius. August 15th, you can meet her. Are you available for marriage proposals?
Actually, I'm engaged.
Oh, get a shot here. Come here, Joe Michelle.
Oh,
as you can see,
you are going to get me in trouble.
He's a big spender.
I just wear my ring all the time.
Oh, that's good. That's the thing when you're on these shows, because a lot of producers from Universal watch it. I wouldn't wear it either.
Well,
I'm sorry.
It does hurt sometimes.
Well, it's supposed to. I mean, love hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It's the same thing. I don't wear my diamonds either because...
I'm in such trouble now.
No, you're not in trouble. Does your husband-to-be have a sense of humor?
No.
No?
Great.
Hi, Bobby.
Hi, Bobby. Hi, everybody. Hi, Bobby. Let's change the subject. Let's go over here and see what Michelle's doing. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Mike.
Having fun? So August 15th, you'll be back.
August 15th.
Will you be hanging out there any of the other Thursdays to see if any of the other girls are
sure,
worthy of your
not?
Crown?
Why not?
Yeah? Who's this Steve guy? So your mother told me nothing about Steve. She said, I'm looking for a nice Jewish guy like you,
oh,
Mike.
Oh, no.
I kept telling her my name was really Goldfarb. And I'm in med school. Your mother liked me.
So that's what you did.
Yeah, that's the way that works. But your mother's Italian, isn't she?
No, my mother's not. My mother's Hungarian. My father's Italian.
I don't know how that goes anyhow. Well, you guys are fabulous.
Thank you.
And is there going to be just one winner? Do you mean someone has to lose, Tom? Or someone has to be the runner-up?
It'll be winner, first, runner-up, and second runner-up.
Winner, first, runner-up, second runner-up. Anything else we need to plug?
Ah!
Fred, let me see you, Fred.
Here
Fred,
I am.
Fred, is there anything here on the show we should plug
everything,
tonight, Fred?
Everything.
okay. Well, we thank you for stopping in. We do appreciate it. Congratulations again,
thank
Laura.
You
were fabulous, and congratulations to you.
Thank you, Mike.
You're the next Mrs. Pacelli, but we already know that. Let's see. Now, we got to let you know where that little yellow piece of paper go. Did anybody see the yellow? Let me see. Give me that. Still this hour now, we're going to meet some of the other girls that were in the contest. You're going to meet Tammy, Kim, and Kim. And Kim McKenzie, right, was one of the finalists also, so you'll meet them on pre-recorded tape. And then I'll be back at 4 o'clock for the lightning round. But we got to let the girls go because it's just too doggone late. And you know what happens if you keep these babes too long? Well, it turns into carnal knowledge. So you guys, say so long. Should I get them to stand again?
Yeah.
Girls, stand while I play out in the next video is what? Elvis Costello, and bye. Say thank you. Bye.